This song is not for you. If you've never cried a river or had your heart broken too, this song is not for you. If every day you wake up, the skies are blue. Hi everyone, you're watching St. John Northwest
Discovery Zone,
where we are discovering the Word of God. If you've ever tuned in before, then you know we have lots of different segments like story time, the Word of God in Spanish, arts and crafts, praise and worship, and so many more. Speaking of which, let's dive into our very first segment.
Trinity and Brian, take it away.
Discovery Zone, it's Trinity and Brian, and we are back with another virtual worship service. But before we start, let's bow our heads for a moment of prayer.
Dear Lord, provide me with the ability to speak kindly and respond gently at times to hold my tongue. I want my actions and reactions to please and reflect you and your love. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Discovery Zone kids and church family, today we are speaking about the sixth beatitude. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God.
What that means is when we let Jesus purify our hearts, we can come into God's presence and spend all of forever with Him. Take time to meditate on this week's scripture and think about your own life.
To be pure in heart is to also be free from contamination. It is to have one focus, one goal as you go about your life, and this goal is to please God. How can we please God, Brian?
Well, we please God by living lives of righteousness and purity. As kids, we can live righteous lives by obeying our parents or guardians, doing well in school, and giving back to people who are in need.
Now, let's go into God's presence and worship. After worship, you will have a story about the Good Samaritan, a story about a good man whose good heart allowed him to be in the presence of God.
Bye!
Oh, story, The Good Samaritan. So part of God's story is about a Good Samaritan, and it goes like this. When Jesus lived on earth, he often told stories to teach us things. Stories that teach a lesson are called parables. One day, Jesus told a parable about a good guy from a place called Samaria, a Good Samaritan, to a group of Jewish people. It all started when a Jewish expert in the law asked Jesus, "What must I do to receive eternal life?" Basically, he was asking, "What do I have to do to be perfect?" Since this guy was an expert in the law, he thought he already knew how to be perfect because he knew all the rules. He just wanted to see what Jesus would say. Of course, Jesus knew what the man was thinking, so he asked him, "What is written in the law?" The man said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as you love yourself." So he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus answered him by telling this story. A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Everybody listening was Jewish, and they could probably all picture the exact road Jesus was talking about. He continued, "A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. You might expect a priest, who was supposed to serve God, to help, but he didn't stop. Then Jesus said, "A Levite came to the place and saw him, but he passed by on the other side too." Levites were assistants to priests, so maybe you'd expect them to help too, but he didn't stop either. Finally, Jesus said, "A Samaritan came along." Remember, a Samaritan is a person from Samaria. That's near Israel, where God's family, the Jews, lived. But here's the thing. Jews and Samaritans didn't get along. In fact, nobody hearing this story would ever expect a Samaritan to help, because Samaritans and Jews couldn't stand each other. But Jesus said, when the Samaritan saw the man and took pity on him, he went to him and bandaged his wounds. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out money and gave it to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will pay you back for any extra expense you have." Then Jesus asked, "Which of these three do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers?" The expert in the law didn't even want to say the word Samaritan, but he admitted, "The one who had mercy on him." Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise." In other words, go and love everyone, even people we don't like or people who everybody else wants to avoid. See, when we show love, we're obeying Jesus. Obeying God doesn't mean just doing what his rules say. It means loving him more than anything and showing his love to every single person that we meet. And that's the story of the Good Samaritan. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. A man asked Jesus how to get eternal life. Jesus said, "What is written in the law?" The man said, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as you love yourself." Then the man asked, "Who is my neighbor?" Jesus told a story. If you missed Jesus' story, here's the quick version. A Jewish man got beat up. A priest walked by. A priest assistant passed by. A man from Samaria actually did help. That was a surprise. Jesus had taught them, we obey God when we show love. And that's part of God's story.
Hi, Discovery Zoners. It is time for the Word of God in Spanish. La Palabra de Dios en Español. Today we are learning our Beatitude number 6. That's right, Bienaventuranza número 6. It comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 8. The book of Mateo, capítulo 5, verso 8. It reads, Bienaventurados los de limpio corazón, porque ellos verán a Dios. Again, it reads, Bienaventurados los de limpio corazón, porque ellos verán a Dios. Blessed are the pure in heart, are the clean in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are those that are clean or pure in heart, for they will see God. So, Discovery Zoners, to be pure at heart means to keep your thoughts clean and make godly decisions. It's a beautiful thing to be pure at heart, and we'll get to see God. All right, Kingdom Kids, until next time, that is La Palabra de Dios en Español. Bienaventuranza número 6. Hope to see you next Sunday. Adios.
Hey everyone, this is Pastor Chris, and I'm so happy that you are here, and we're about to play a game of, wait for it, Bible trivia, yes, we're about to play a game of Bible trivia, and I'm your host, Pastor Chris, and this is what you will need. You will need a pencil, paper, Bible, and an open mind for all the information that we are about to impart in you. So get ready to play a game of Bible trivia. All right, let's go for it. Are you ready for the first question? I'm ready for the first question. Let's get with it. Here goes the first question. So where in the Bible do the Beatitudes come from? Is it A, Matthew? Is it B, Luke? Is it C, John? Or is it D, both A and B? And I'm going to give you 20 seconds to think about it. Again, is it A, Matthew? Is it B, Luke? Is it C, John? Or is it D, both A and B? All right, the answer is, get ready. Let's get a little drum roll action going. It is both A and B, both A and B. And B. And this is a little background information on that answer. So you will see the Beatitudes mentioned the first time in Matthew chapter 5, verses 3 to 12. And this is when Jesus gave his famous speech, and it's called Sermon on the Mount. You also see the Beatitudes reference again in Luke chapter 6, verses 20 to 23. In this retelling, we see that it is called the Sermon on the Plain. Interesting. And maybe when you get a chance, you could compare both versions of that famous gospel account in both scripture references. All right, you all, let's keep going for the next question. All right, fill in the blank. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall what God? Shall they see God? Shall they hear God? Shall they become God? Or shall they feel God? Again, the answer to that question is, will they see God? Will they hear God? Will they become God? Or will they feel God? I want you to really, really think about it. Think about it. Hey. Thinking about it. Y'all know I'm crazy. All right, let's get ready for the answer. Let's see what we have here. All right, the answer is C. They shall see God. They shall see God. Blessed are the pure heart, for they shall see God. Don't you know when you live a life of righteousness and integrity and you pray and you do what's right and you're obedient, it allows you to see God. And what that means is you're able to experience his presence. You're able to see his guidance in your life. It's such a wonderful thing. Are you ready for the next question? I'm ready for the next question. Let's get at it. All right. This is the next question. Let's get it loaded up. Here we go. Oh, that's not the next question. This is the next question. All right. What is the famous speech that Jesus gives in which the Beatitudes are featured? Is it Sermon the Grass? Is it B, Sermon on the Mount? Is it C, Sermon on the Hill? Hey. Or is it D, Lily on the Valley? Which one is it? Is it A, Sermon on the Grass? Is it B, Sermon on the Mount? Is it C, Sermon on the Hill? Hey, I don't know why that makes me do that every time, but I love that answer choice. And D, Lily on the Valley. I want you to think about it. I'm going to give you some thinking time. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to be grooving. Hey, which one are you picking? Are you getting help from your parents? That's cool if you are. That's what you should be doing. All right, let's see what the answer is. Are you ready for it? I'm ready for it. It is B, Sermon on the Mount. What is the famous speech that Jesus gives in which the Beatitudes are featured? It is B, Sermon on the Mount. Sermon on the Mount. All right, let's go to the next question. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? I'm ready. And I think this is our final question for today. So you better get your thinking caps on. If you ain't been doing too good, this is your time to redeem yourself, mom and dad. I'm just playing. Let's go for it. All right, next question. A synonym or similar word to beatitude is what? Is it what? Is it A, compassion? Is it B, proclamation? Is it C, blessing? Or is it D, worship? Right? Which one is it? Which one is it? I want you to get your thinking cap. This is the last one. This is for all the coins. Do you know it? Do you have it? Let's see what the answer is. The answer is C, blessing. You got to understand, when Jesus was on the Sermon on the Mount, yes, it was a form of proclamation. Yes, he was showing compassion. And yeah, people were probably even worshiping him, right? But however, the word beatitude means blessing, because when Jesus was on that mount preaching and teaching, he was proclaiming blessings over the people, beatitudes. So when we read the Beatitudes, we must understand that it is Jesus proclaiming blessings over us. And with that being said, that brings our time together to an end. No, 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 no. Say it ain't so, right? But with that being said, my final thought to you, or my final challenge to you, is the video challenge. And I want you to think about it. So our video challenge for this week is, I want you to find an object in your house that represents, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. And I want you to film a 1-minute message explaining why that object reminds you of our scripture focus for today. So send us your final product at stjohnnorthwestmedia@gmail.com. And you never know, you might be featured in our next virtual worship experience. Well, that's all I have for you today. It has been a ball. It has been a blast. And of course, it has been fun. You be blessed. I proclaim nothing but beatitudes over your life. And I'll see you next time for another edition of Bible Trivia. Until next time, y'all. Peace.
For a faithful trip to the National Museum of African American History and Culture in Washington, Elena Mitchell said she didn't feel like she was black enough to own African American history as her own. But she found a place in history within its walls, along with a handful of her classmates from Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Early College, a middle and high school in Denver, Colorado. During the high school's 2019 visit to the D.C. Museum, students, including Elena, were overcome with emotion. They felt heartbreak, anger, and confusion. They were surrounded by the rich history of black artists, politicians, and activists at the museum. So why weren't they taught anything about them in class? It's sad that we had to travel 1,000 miles away to learn about ourselves, Elena said. And if we hadn't traveled 1,000 miles away, where would we be right now? So Elena and her classmates made a demand to their school board, require African American studies courses at every Denver public school, and teach black history in every grade. So far, they've guaranteed a course at their own school with plans for expansion. It's a victory, if an incomplete one, in the thick of a nationwide reckoning with racism and a pandemic that's disproportionately killed black Americans. Students and faculty in local communities across the nation are demanding better black history programs in schools, from lesson plans that lay bare the horrors of the Tulsa Race Massacre, to literature units that center on black authors and black experiences. Young activists and their faculty supporters seek an urgent need for education reform. Educators who support bringing black history into schools say visibility is critical for young black students who haven't seen themselves in subjects before, like Elena and her Denver classmates. If it weren't for the trip to the D.C. Museum, the students said, they may have not ever known what they'd been missing. Black history doesn't need to be relegated to a week in February or one unit in U.S. history, proponents say. It doesn't even need to be restricted to social studies. U.S. schools have failed in the past to support their black students. Now is the time to center young black Americans in their own stories. This is Elijah Carter Fusilier for Kingdom Kids Discovery Zone News.
Thanks for the news story, Elijah.
Today was a great day of Discovery Church. We learned the importance of having a pure heart.
We also learned about it in Spanish.
And we watched a film about the Good Samaritan that taught us what God meant to have a pure heart. Stay blessed, Discovery Zone Church. Bye.